morning, everyone. Welcome to a new video. This morning we are getting into squats. Let's chat real quick. Today went good. I would not say it was great. I had higher expectations for the day. Not much higher. Let's start from the beginning. So Sunday during my workout, I think it was during the hack squat, I ended up kind of hurting my back, like tweaking it a little bit. I'm really not sure what happened, but it's like my erector on the right side. Anyways, got better obviously as I like moved around and stuff, so I was like, it's gonna be fine. Let me just make sure like this morning that I get in, get really warmed up, I'll be good. Shouldn't like affect me too much. And then I unracked my second warm up and my back cramped up. Like it just seized up so bad. I had to re-rack it. Like, It scared me more than anything, just because I haven't felt something like that before. And of course, it did not feel good. It wasn't like a sharp pain. It was just like very uncomfortable. So then my mind is racing, like, am I going to be able to like squat today? I'm supposed to do singles. I'm supposed to go up again next week. Like, but you know how your mind just starts racing. But I was like, gonna be okay. I'm not like hurt. It's uncomfortable. Let me put on my belt, make sure I brace really well. I'll be fine. So that's what I did. Popped on my belt for the rest of the warm-ups. And just braced really hard, and it did not, like, I didn't feel anything during the squats. I feel everything after the squats, but I didn't feel anything during the squats, so that was good. Worked up to a single at 330. Overall, like, to be hitting that weight, especially after, you know, back and everything this morning, but just in general, to be hitting that weight and it moving so well, it's good. I mean, my max is 341, so we're only 10 pounds under that. So this is still huge to be hitting that number. It's been times before I didn't ever think I'd be able to hit that number, or I was hitting it, but not very well. So I have a little bit of Larson press to do now. It's uncomfortable to get into position, but I found once I got into position, I didn't feel it when I was actually doing the Larson press. So that's good. I am hoping I can rehab this, get it feeling better before, I was about to say before my next workout, but that's tomorrow morning. So we'll see how tomorrow morning goes. I'll keep y'all updated. But let me go. I feel like all of this is going to get copyrighted because of this music. So let me get this press done. And then I want to go get some coffee, because whenever I have a bad day, I want coffee. It wasn't a bad day, but I just want coffee now. So Let me get this done so we can go get coffee. What's up, guys? I'm gonna hop on here and give y'all a quick little tutorial on how I wrap my wrist straps. As you can see, we've got these thumb loops on the ends of the wrist straps. So a lot of people will use these and put them through their thumb to get started, but in competition, you can't have that around your thumb. You need to take it off before you do the lift. A lot of people will still use it to wrap their wrist straps on, like hold it still while they do that, and then we'll try to, you know, pull it off once the wrist strap's on. I personally don't like doing that, so what I will do is I just fold it down. I don't even use it, so I will fold it down, and then I'm gonna put it like right here on my hand, and I'm gonna reach down and I grab it right there. So then I'm just gonna hold it still in that position while I wrap around. That's how I personally like to do it. You can use the loop, but I don't like having to then try to pry it off my thumb afterwards or forgetting it before a lift. So I've just gotten used to doing it this way. So this is my left hand. I will have the wrist strap coming out. I don't even know the proper way to say this. But coming over my thumb is going that way. So a lot of people you might see, we'll do it this way. That's just never how I've done it. I found this to be the best. So I'm just giving y'all my opinion how I do it. There's many ways to do it. But what I really wanted to show you is where I actually wrap the wrist strap around. Because wrist strap, it shouldn't be like just right here around the wrist. You want to actually like support. You actually want to support that hand and the forearm. So how I do it is we're going to first start here. We're going to put it there. Hold it. And then my first wrap is going to be almost around the bottom of the hands. So we're going to fully cover that. Then I go down. You can see we go down diagonally a little bit. And then we're going to come up, back up to the mid wrist or where that first wrap went. And then over. So now I have support down here, I have support up here around the hands, and of course the wrist. So it's like it's fully supported now. What's great about these wrist straps is they are flexible enough. I can still get, you know, some bend a little bit, so it's a good support. So what you don't want to do is take the wrist strap and just, you know, crank it just right here. Then look, my hand can move, my forearm can move like everywhere. So you don't want it just right there. You really want to get up to here, down there, and get it diagonally across to get that full support. So that was probably not the best explanation, but hopefully that helped a little bit most out of your wrap from the wrist strap. So, all right, we've got this set of, got this set of one. 80 kilos, so let me get this done real quick. Also, I want to say real quick, my back is feeling better. I'm just going to keep kind of, I didn't feel it at all when I was deadlifting or benching. I feel it when I'm just kind of moving around, but not feeling it during lifts, so that's a good thing. Struggle. Stick around. It's gonna be fun to watch. Thankfully. Get my nails done today, so even if I break one, it's okay. These are tight. It's only around my ankle, and it feels tight. Why didn't I size up for these? It's kind of stupid of me. I need to get through these sets fast. I'm gonna make some crazy faces doing this. They're like comfortable, but they are tight too. It's a weird combination. We're in. Let's get these hot spots done.
Thank you. got home from the Oak City Open at Bucked Up Fitness today. If you came out, supported, say hi, what's up? We appreciate you. It was good to see everyone, good to support the local lifters. Had a lot of friends competing. It was so much fun to watch them lift and just hang out. It's like, it's a good community that we have around here. So it was a good time. Long day, so I'm really tired. But I'm gonna close out the video here. As always, thank you for watching. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I will see y'all in the next one.